Lakeside Solarium. And we're at the port of Seattle, Terminal 91. There is the Needle in the distance. Beautiful scenery. And then everything else. Oh, nice. Very interesting. Look at all that. Here we go. We're going to the 270 Theater, which is towards the aft of the ship on deck 5. It's kind of very interesting. Good morning. Good morning. There we go. And we got some beautiful artwork. There's this Jamie Oliver's restaurant. And this ship, I realize, and a lot of shops. This ship has a lot of shops. Okay, so here we come to the Royal Esplanade. bar. And we'll walk over there shortly. Alright, so Sorrento, very large, very nice. Just if you want to go shopping, that's kind of interesting. And here we go. There's the Royal Theater over there. Okay. With this little interesting vehicle. Deck 15, that's deck 14 down there. You can see the enclosed pool, which is open a lot, and then of course the hot tub, which goes all the time. And then we're going to go outside to take a look at the running track, which is on deck 15 here. Down here is forward. So if we go around the front, beautiful. Alright, walking aft, here is that's the wave pool over there, and here's the outdoor pool, and there's the North Star. Pretty good ride. Let's walk further back of the ship and see what we got to look at. There we go. That's what everybody's doing. Alright, we have these bump outs, which turns out that they're part of the C-Plex, which is inside this glassed area. That's where they have the bumper cars, the roller skating, basketball, you know, table tennis, Xbox games, all of that. So we'll take a look here in a second. Yes, here's the C-Plex. And the game room's up on top. And then the bumper cars over there. And this also has areas for you to sit around and do things. And it also has the hot dog house. And let's go all the way to the back, because the only thing left is the iFly and the Flow Rider. As we get to the back, we're gonna go up one more level. So this will be technically deck 16, I guess. And then we have the thing that Royal Caribbean is famous for is their Flow Rider. But also on this ship is, on the Quantum of course, is the iFly experience. We'll see if we get around to that, but yeah, here we go. As we get to the starboard side, in the aft we have the rock climbing wall. And we have the large artwork that the Quantum series is known for. All right. And then we're going back. Where's the last floor? And there's the Luxor right there. Yeah, kind of scary. But we're on deck 14, which is the Windjammer. This also has a dim sum restaurant that has never been open, and we've been told that it would not be open. So that is something we did not get to try, but hopeful. But here's the Windjammer. Let's go take a walk through the Windjammer, get some coffee, and take a look at an interesting feature of the Quantum series regarding the Windjammer. This also on the starboard side has the coastal kitchen for those sweet guests. So let's wash our hands and go and get some continental breakfast. And you have this beautiful outdoor adventure. Just look around. Beautiful. Watch the sunrise, the sunset. Enjoy the scenery. Yeah. All right, guys. That's the tour of my little vacation on the Quantum of the Seas to Alaska. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you for subscribing and have a wonderful day. Thank you for watching another video.